We believe that the actor is capable of creating reality to a greater extent than in any other art.
Unfortunately, you haven't the slightest idea of what I or the teachers have been telling you, because the preconceptions is in terms of the result, not of what you have to create. If you don't know what you're going to have to create, you will never in your life create it.
For me, whatever step anybody has achieved is always only the prelude to something more. It's an unending series of steps. There's no point at which you get to the top floor. Nobody knows where the top floor is.
He said, you know, always have a little reserve. Don't go to the top of what you got. Stay under it. Don't hit the top. Don't hit that top note, you know? And because there's the tendency for the actor to want to really feel that they're really fulfilling whatever it is they're trying to fulfill if they go as far as you can go. And he always would say, pull it back.
What I feel about the theater is, very simply, it is the art that is closest to reality. Because whereas all the other arts transform reality into a different medium, sound, music, words on a page, you see, painting, and so on and so forth, they capture life, but by transforming it onto, not mechanical, but to a totally different medium. In the theater, and that includes the movies too from that point of view, because to me that those are the theater mediums, the living presence of the actor means that you are creating art with the same means that you create life.
Of course, Lee Strasberg is one of the most famous acting teachers in the world.
If you have picked an incident that has within itself some motivation, it may suggest to you something to do. Otherwise, frankly, you're going to stand there on the stage, you will not know what to do, and the only thing that you will know is to remember the lines. And that is not the way we become actors. The very word acting has nothing to do with memory in that sense. It has to do with what we do, how we behave on the stage, how we make whatever we're doing real.
He continues to inspire and push and encourage those young people who care about acting.
All these things you have to create because the stage is going to be pretty light. So you're not going to get it from the stage itself. You're going to get it only from the way in which we commonly say your imagination creates it. But the imagination is nothing more than all these real things taking place unconsciously. When they don't happen, the imagination doesn't work, the inspiration doesn't work, and the actor is left only with the lines and with what Stanislavski calls the muscles of the tongue.
Among the actors who have studied with Lee Strasberg are Paul Newman, Anne Bancroft, Dustin Hoffman, Jane Fonda, Marlon Brando, Geraldine Page, Al Pacino, Susan Strasberg, Carl Malden, Joanne Woodward, James Dean, Julie Harris, Montgomery Clift, Lee Grant, Marilyn Monroe, Steve McQueen, Shelley Winters.
You have that naturally, but when you did it here, you went so much with the personal thing that you lost some of the things that they have, that she has. I lost, in the way in which you cried, I lost the character. You would have to be aware of what's going on, your heart breaks.
There are a lot of cliches around about what method acting is, you know, like if you tear your t-shirt, you're a method actor. And that's really not it. It's the method just simply means a method of work, an approach to work, so that you can connect with your character on as deep a level as possible.
I tell people when they're joking about method, I am a method actor, always. And whether I'm doing Norma Rae or something seemingly lightweight and silly, I am quintessentially a method actor. I prepare totally with the methods with which I was taught. So I would never lose the accent. I would wear the clothes she would wear. I would go and work in the mill.
Whatever it is, I didn't do it.
I would walk around and use whatever exercises to find her walk and find her rhythm and be it. So that you were no longer acting. You were behaving.
What Lee's training was to learn how not to lie. to really tell the truth. How not to act, that's what he taught. How not to pretend, to not act as though I feel bad, but to feel bad.
American acting is, it has been influenced by Lee Strasberg. There's a guy who's this acting guru, whether it's been earned or not, I don't know, it's just that that's his reputation. And he's asked now to act. And he didn't even flinch, he just said, yeah, I'll do it.
There was this kid I grew up with. He was younger than me. Sort of looked up to me, you know. We did our first work together. Worked our way out of the street. Things were good. We made the most of it. During Prohibition, we ran molasses into Canada. Made a fortune. Your father, too. As much as anyone, I loved him and trusted him. Later on, he had an idea to build a city out of a desert stopover for GIs on the way to the West Coast. That kid's name was Mo Green, and the city he invented was Las Vegas. This was a great man. Man of vision and guts. And there isn't even a plaque or a signpost or a statue of him in that town. Someone put a bullet through his eye. No one knows who gave the order. When I heard it, I wasn't angry. I knew Mo, I knew he was headstrong, talking loud, saying stupid things. So when he turned up dead, I let it go. And I said to myself, this is the business we've chosen. I didn't ask who gave the order, because it had nothing to do with business.
He's terrific in the film. I think it's like a kind of manifesto of what the method gives to the film actor. You look at that performance, and on the surface, the character seems absolutely bland, but underneath the subtext, you see that the character's cruelty, his ruthlessness. After all, he's a mafioso. He's a vicious character, but he plays him like, on the surface, like a sympathetic, absolutely humble, modest, unassuming Jewish grandfather.
To become a character.
Nobody becomes that. I don't believe that anybody is. First of all, you can't act unless you are what you are and who you are.
If you'd come to me in friendship, then the scum that ruined your daughter would be suffering this very day. And if by chance an honest man like yourself should make enemies, then he would become my enemies. And then they would fear you.
I think that we couldn't survive a second if we weren't able to act. That acting is a survival mechanism, and it's a social unguent, and it's a lubricant. And we act to save our lives, actually, every day. People lie constantly, every day, by not saying something that they think, or saying something that they don't think.
What is acting? What do you tell
them? So what we're doing right now, that's acting.
Listen, everybody in this life is an actor. Nobody goes around, wake up in the morning and you say, hi, how are you? You son of a bitch. And people don't say what they want. How many men and women find other men and women attractive and pretend to be casual and just buff their nails and be sort of bored with the whole thing and are really impassioned by that? How many times have you seen a woman wearing a really ugly dress and say, oh, I'm so glad you could come, Meg, sit down, please. God, you've got an ugly dress on. Where did you get that dress? It's really repulsive. How many times have you done that? Never. You've just said, hi, Meg, how are you? Come and sit down. Wonderful to see you. That's acting.
Yeah, but that's not acting.
That is acting. That is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
But you know what I mean. You,
when you're
what you
frightened
do on the
or
screen,
when you're nervous, huh? When you're frightened or nervous in this chair, you're distressed or uncomfortable or you're very angry.
Yeah.
And you know that that is not what is necessary to what cannot be shown here. You control your face. You're a highly controlled person. And
really?
James Caan and Al Pacino, they all considered you to be such a great teacher.
Really? How do you know that?
Read that. Heard
you
about it.
You read it?
Heard about it.
Heard about it? You shouldn't ever believe what you hear, and you shouldn't ever believe what you read.
Don't you realize that you're thought of as the greatest actor ever?
What's the difference? See, that's a part of the sickness in America, that you have to think in terms of who wins, who loses, who's good, who's bad, who's best, who's worst. We always think in those terms, in extreme terms. I don't like to think that way.
I never wanted this for you. I worked my whole life. I don't apologize to take care of my family. And I refused to be a fool. Dancing on the string, held by all those big shots. I don't apologize, that's my life, but I thought that when it was your time, that you would be the one to hold the strings. Senator Corleone, Governor Corleone, something.
I'm not a peasant of Anta.
This wasn't enough time, Michael. Wasn't enough time.
We'll get there, Pop. We'll get there.
Now listen, whoever comes to you with this Barzini meeting, he's a traitor. Don't forget that.
I believe in supporting my children, and it takes money to do that. I've had all kinds of jobs in this world, and I started out shoveling horse manure, and I wound up as an actor.
It is much easier for me to make movies than to do the work that I think to be my major work, which is to help other people, because I don't have to argue with myself. I don't have to talk to myself. I don't have to convince myself. Whatever I do, and so on, and there's no difficulty. But to try to get somebody else to do what I think he's capable of, to somehow stimulate, because I can't do it, he has to do it, after all. So I can, to stimulate, to hit the right button, the right kind of thing that will ignite in him the thing that I see him to be capable of. That's hard work, let me tell you. There's only one thing that differentiates people, and that's the degree of talent that they have. That does differentiate people. People are in that sense unequal, you see, the degree of talent. But there again, one never knows who will possess the talent, who will become the great artist, even the great scientist and so on, who will make the great discovery. We don't know. We never know.